Good day, everyone. I am Teacher Anton na magtuturo at magagabay sa inyo ng mga ilang pamaraan kung paano mag-solve ng math. Ang topic ko ngayon ay geometric sequence. The question is, determine the positive geometric mean between the given numbers. I prepared two questions and ipapakita ko sa inyo kung paano to isolve. Now, let's start. Number one, from the question is geometric mean. Geometric mean between any two positive terms of geometric sequence is given by the square root of their product. So, let us denote that the geometric mean as x. So, x is equals, as I said, the square root of their product. So, to find the product, we have a square root. Square root of the given, which is 3 over 4 times 16 over 27. Now, continue. Before we get the square root, we need to find first to multiply the fraction to get the product. 3, 4 times 16 over 27. So, you just multiply the numerator to numerator and then multiply the denominator to denominator. So 3 times 16 is equal to 48 over 4 times 27 is equals to 100. Square root of 48 over 108 is equals to 3rd. So the x or the geometric mean is 2/3. Now that's a simple solution, but we have another formula. We may also use the formula of a sub n equals a sub 1 r, or represent as ratio, and n minus 1. So this is the formula. After we use this formula, if the answer is similar from the first solution, it's correct. If different, this formula is wrong. So let's try. Now, the a sub n, a sub 3, which is a sub 3 is the given from this sequence, which is 16 over 27 is equals to 16 over 27. And a sub 1, usually the 3/4. 3/4. And n is equals to 3, which is 3. So now, substitute. So a sub 3 equals a sub 1, which is 3/4. 3/4. And r, n is 3 minus 1. So the value of a sub 3 is 16 over 27. Bring down 3/4 r, subtract the 3 minus 1 is equals to 2. Now, from this formula, we need to find first the divide both side by 3/4. It to remain the r squared. To cancel, becomes 1 for r squared. 16 over 27 divided by 3/4 or 16 over 27 reciprocal of 3/4 times 4/3. Continue. R squared, 16 times 4,
64.
27 times 3 is 81. Then apply the square root, 64 over 81.
Square root,
cancel, becomes R, and the remain will be 64 and 81. So we're done? No. So find the square root of 64 over 81. The square root of 64 over 81
is equals to 8
over 9. Now we have the ratio is 8 over 9. So from the arithmetic mean, no, from the geometric mean is 2/3, but not yet done. So to find the geometric mean, you need to multiply the ratio times a sub 1. So R is 8 over 9 times a sub 1 is 3/4. Multiply the numerator to numerator and denominator to denominator. So 8 times 3, 24. Over 9 times 4, 36. So then simplify. If you can simplify the fraction, do it. And if can't, then that is the final. So now let's try if we can simplify 24 over 36 by dividing by 12. So 12. 24 divided by 12 is equals to 2. And 36 divided by 12
answer
is 3.
Is 2/3.
So what have you observed? From the short solution, we have the arithmetic mean 2/3. And from the other solution, but the same answer is 2/3. So which one do you like to use the solution? From this long solution or from short? Siyempre, pahirapan mo pa ang sarili mo sa mataas na solution is same answer naman, di ba? So we use the small short solution from this one. It's same answer. So now, let's proceed.
Let us
denote that the geometric mean as x is equal to square root negative 9 times negative 81. Negative 9 times negative 81 is equals to 729. Now find the square root of 729 is equals to 27. The geometric mean between the given numbers is 27. And from the questions here, number 1, between the
geometric
numbers is
2.
If you will use this formula, no need to use this one. It because it's the same answer. So if you want to use this one, you can use. And if you want to use this, you can use also. So it depends on you what formula that you want to use. As long as that you can get the geometric mean between the given numbers. So now, let's proceed to the next task. Will be the questions
determine
here.
Determine the indicated term in the given geometric sequence.
So I prepared three questions.
First
is find a sub 7 from the given sequence, which is 2, 3, and 4.5. And
you
so
will
on.
Use the formula of the a sub n equals a sub 1 R, which is the ratio, and N minus 1. You can use that formula to find the A sub 7. So before you will get the A sub 7, you need to find first
how to
the
find
ratio.
The ratio.
Let's try from A sub 3.
The value of A sub 3
is from the given sequence here is 2, 3, 4.5. So first term is 2, second 3, and the third is 4.5. So 4.5, and A sub 1 is equals to 2, and N is equals to 3. A sub 3 equals A sub 1 or 3 minus 1. So why is it 3? It's because you will use A sub 3. So that's why N,
the value of A sub
3
is
4.5. The A sub 1 is 2. R, then 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Then divide both sides by 2 to remain the R squared. So 2 divided by 2 is 1 or equals to R squared. Then 4.5 over 2. So R squared is 4.5 divided by 2 is equals to 2.25. Then apply
to
the square root
of the power of 2,
then it becomes R, which is the ratio. Then square root of 2.25 in fraction
3/2.
Now we are done finding the ratio, which is 3/2. Then continue. You will use again this formula to find the A sub 7. So A sub 7 equals A sub 1. What is the value of A sub 1? 2. What is the value of R? 3/2. The power of 7 minus 1. Why is it 7? It's because we find the value of A sub 7. So since A sub 7, so the N is equal to 7. Continue, A sub 7. 2 times 3/2, 7 minus 1, 6. Then A sub 7, 2, then 3/2 to the power of 6 is equals to 729 over 64 times. Then A sub 7, 2 times 729 over 64. So we have an imaginary 1 here. So 2 times 729
is equals to 1458
over 1 times 64 equals 64. So now we have a fraction from A sub 7. Now let's, what is the decimal 1458 form?
1458 over 64.
So we use decimal form 22.78. So this is the value of A sub 7. So, or you will use the fraction, which is 2225 over 32. So this is the fraction form of 22.78. So you can use this final answer. Now let's start number 2. A sub n is equals to A sub 1 or n minus 1. Then find the value of A sub 3 is equals to, from the given we have negative 1. The value of a sub 3 is negative 1, and a sub 1 is equals to negative 16, and n is equals to 3. Find the ratio by using this formula. A sub 3 equals a sub 1 is negative 16, or the value of n is 3 minus 1. What is the value of a sub 3? Negative 1. Negative 16, or 3 minus 1, 2. Continue. Negative 1. Negative 16 r squared. Divide both sides by negative 16. Then cancel. It becomes r squared equals negative 1 divided by negative 16. R squared positive 1 over 16. Then apply the square root. Comes r. Square root of 1 over 16 is equals to 1/4. So we have here the ratio, which is 1/4. Now continue. We need to find the a sub 6, which is from the questions here. So a sub 6, find the value. A sub 6 equals a sub 1 is negative 16, value of r, or the ratio, is 1/4, then n is 6 minus 1. A sub 6 negative 16 times 1/4. 6 minus 1, 5. A sub 6, negative 16. 1/4 to the power of 1, 5 over 1024 times. So A sub 6, negative 16 times 1 over 1024. So we have an imaginary 1, so negative 16 times 1, it becomes negative 16 over 1024. So the value of a sub 6 is equal to negative 16 over 1024. So you can simplify. Yes. So it becomes a sub 6 equals negative 1/64. So this is the value of the term of a sub 6. Question here is number 3, which is a sub 9. The sequence are 18, negative 6, and positive formula. A sub n is equal to a sub 1 or n minus 1. A sub 3 equals a sub 1 is equals to positive 18, n is equals to 3. We use always the third term, so we can apply the square root of the product. The value of a sub 3 is 2 equals a sub 1 is 18. Then then r 3 minus 1. 2, 18, r 3 minus 1, 2. Then 2, 18, r squared. Divide both sides by 18 to remain the r squared. r squared, it becomes 2 over 18. Then r squared equals 2 over 18. Apply the square root. Cancel. Then it remains is r. The square root of 2 over 18.
1/3.
So the ratio is a sub 9 equals a sub 1 is 18. R is 1/3 times n minus 1. Or n is equals to 9.
A sub 9, 18 times 1/3, 9 minus 1 is 8.
A sub 9, 18, 1/3 to the power of equals 1 8. Over 6,561 times. Don't forget the parentheses to represent as multiplication. So a sub 9 we have an imaginary one. 18 times 1 equals 18 over 1 times 6,561 is 6,561. Then divide. The answer is a sub 9 is equals to 2 over 729. So this is the final answer. So you can simplify 18 over 6,561 by dividing by 9 over. So the answer is here. So that's it. Thank you and God bless to us.